Hello, hello, good people. This is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker, coming back at you live once again from the Lone Star State with another edition of the Media Mike Speaks. All right, good people. One of my subscribers sent me the story. I don't know what's going on here with these judges. We got the ones in Indiana getting into fights and getting shot. And we've had the other judges a few years ago doing a whole bunch of outrageous stuff here in our own Lone Star State. And now we have another incident because I believe it is an election year. Yes, it is. So as you saw in the title, I put in Judge Clay Jenkins on the ropes. He'll probably come off of him. So he's up for re-election and he's being challenged. And an opponent says back in 1983, Dallas County Judge Clay Jenkins, when he was a student at Baylor University, Baylor Bears, wore blackface when he did a prank by breaking into some females. I don't know if it was the dorm or apartments. Think of the apartments. And trying to scare them. I don't know if it was around Halloween or what. I don't know. You know, but anyway, they're saying it was distasteful. Not a good look. Now, since taking office in 2011, Judge Clay Jenkins has become a voice for a stronger and more welcoming North Texas. He led the responses to public health emergencies like the West Nile virus epidemic, Ebola crisis, and natural disaster recovery from deadly tornadoes and flooding. But now this incident could be threatening to derail his political career here in the Metroplex. The 1983 incident was reported soon after it happened by the Baylor student paper. And again in 2014 in the magazine when Jenkins was seeking a second term. Well, see, it didn't stop him then. I don't see how it's going to stop him now. I really don't. Maybe it was overshadowed in 2014. I don't know. Now, in the interview, according to the challenger, and the challenger's name is Davis, I'm not mistaken, it's Davis. She says it was anything but a prank. He could have been shot, which is true. He broke in and entered a home dressed not as himself and then terrorized these women. He ransacked the apartment. The women barricaded themselves behind the door, unquote. Now, since that time, Judge Jenkins has apologized. He said when he was 19 and continues to be sorry for the poor judgment he exhibited at the time. He has never darkened his face in an attempt to appear as a member of another race, unquote. Well, see, that's where things get kind of funny. Because, see, according to the police report, at that time, one of the women awoke in the early hours of September 22nd, 1983, to see what appeared to be three possibly black males. Now, why would she describe them as possibly black males? But we all know how they go. You know, considering the history of race relations in this country. Anyway, let's continue. What appeared to be three possibly black males coming through the window. She woke her roommate and dragged her into another room where they hid as the men ransacked their room. Then one of the men called out the woman's name. She told police, which is when she realized that she knew at least two of the intruders, including Jenkins. Another roommate chased the man out of the apartment through the front door as they laughed, according to the report. The women decided to press charges. I'm surprised, wow. And the three men came to Waco Police Headquarters to speak to an officer, the report says. One of them told the officer that the incident was a Baylor prank and said they had entered the apartment trying to scare the girls and they all left laughing, thinking it was funny, unquote. Jenkins and the other two men were charged with criminal trespass of a habitation, you know, that's a home. The report says, according to the criminal records, Jenkins was sentenced to 1 year of deferred adjudication, a type of probation. yeah, okay. The wearing of blackface, which was a mainstay of minstrel shows and other demeaning depictions of African Americans, especially during the Jim Crow era, has come up in several political races in recent years. Yeah, like the guy, Governor Ralph Northam of Virginia, but you know, all the African Americans forgave him. So anyway, did the women lie? So you're saying the women did not think it was three African American males? See. Now, there were things also said that Judge Jenkins participated in back in 1983. You know, the things that college, you know, things that college young men do. I thought that was irrelevant. But this, if it is true, which they saying it is, that he had on shoe polish or whatever they had on his face, camouflage or whatever it was, I don't know. See, that takes a different turn. You see, it's like you're trying to pass the buck. So you already know how back in the day, how African Americans were accused of crimes they did not commit. And here you are, if this is true allegedly, you're running around here in blackface hoping that you'll be exonerated because it wasn't you. The young ladies would say it was three black men, which she did thought at first it was. See, that's what I don't like. See, what I don't like is that if this is true, this is what you were trying to do. This is what you were trying to imply. To exonerate yourself and say, it wasn't us. We were nowhere around. It was three African American men. Considering the history of race relations in this country, see, that's not funny. Everything else could have been easily excused. You know, the pranks that young men do on college campuses. But this, no. You know, even though you were 19, see, your mentality is pretty much formed as far as your ideals and way of thinking to a certain degree of how you feel about certain people. People of color, that is, you know, African Americans. See, I don't know about this one. I don't know. But here's the thing. Is what gets me. Just like Governor Ralph Northam of Virginia was in the school yearbook, medical school, wearing blackface. The African Americans forgave him. Because we all know forgiveness is a big thing among African Americans. You know how a lot of them do that. So it's the Jesus thing. But let me know what you think about this here. I don't know this man. You know, I have nothing against him, but just for this to come to light that you would do something like this, and in my mind, make it seem like it wasn't you. So if you'd have gotten away with it, and the young ladies would have reported this to the police, they would have been running around in Waco, on the Baylor campus or throughout the city looking for three African American young men. And God help them if they would have found three African American young men happen to be walking around somewhere on campus or off campus. We know this still goes on today, but we're talking 1983, not far from 1963. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night.
They'll understand you soon, it won't be long.
Keep on, keep running.